Today's topic for discussion is a topic of plant pathology, and today's disease for discussion is corn smut disease. Corn is a very important cereal crop which is grown throughout the world. The corn smut disease is cosmopolitan disease because it occurs throughout the world. So it is called cosmopolitan in distribution. In India, the disease occurs in every state where the corn is grown, and especially it is extensively occur in Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, Kashmir and several places. The importance of the disease is the amount of damage resulting from this disease in India is not much, but much importance is therefore not given to the disease is in this country as compared with other countries. This crop is extensively grown in America, and corn is extensively used as a food in America, and there the disease damage is serious because it is extensively grown. The damage includes sterility of diseased plants. There is reduction in yield and amount of fodder, and there are smutted ears which spread the disease in the field. Next, let us see the symptoms of the disease. In the PPT, photograph is shown. This is the corn smut disease, photograph of corn smut disease. The disease is very easily recognizable because of its swellings on the grains, and the sooty swellings or boils known as smut galls or balls. No other symptom appear on the host plant before the formation of smut ball. The growth of the plant shows normal, but when the ear formation takes place, the smutty balls are formed because of the modification of the grain, because of interaction of the pathogen. The latter appear on the ears or stem, and tumors are also formed on the leaves, and they are much smaller in size. The galls at an early stage are light colored and are edible. At this stage, they are covered with a firm shining membrane. It is greenish white in color. Towards maturity, the tumors turn sooty due to spore formation inside. The covering membrane gradually dries and finally bursts open to release the spores which are present in that. The powdery mass of smutty spores are released, and they are very small in size, easily translocated from one place to another. The disease is localized and not systemic. Each tumor or the outgrowth is the result of separate and distinct infection. Unlike other cereal smuts, the fungus mycelium does not enter the plant. The infection takes place through the meristematic tissue of the overgrown part of the host plant. Okay, let us see the causal organism of corn smut disease. The disease is caused by the Ustilago meadis. The black, generally spherical, it produces black colored spores, generally spherical spores, heavily cannulate means designed the, and smut spores, these spores are known as smut spores. And these are the resting spores. They remain in air as well as in soil for long duration. They overwinter on the crop refuse in the soil or in the manure of the cattle fed on the diseased corn. Let us see the disease cycle of the corn smut disease. What happens? The primary inoculum comes from the air, because the spores are very small in size, uninucleated, unicellular, ecannulate. They remain suspended in the air for long duration, and waterborne sporidia or basidiospores, which are produced by the telitospores overwintering on the crop refuse or crop residue, or they remain in the soil, rarely on the grain itself. Even the spores associated with the grains. The tilleto spores are spherical to elliptical in form, black in color, and acanulate. Acanulate means designdar. Each tilleto spore measures about 8 to 11 mu in diameter. Let us see the germination of tilleto spore. The tilleto spore germinate under suitable conditions, and they require temperature and moisture. Each grow into a septate cylinder promycelium, and on each promycelium the basidiospores are developed. The basidiospores are also known as sporidia. Okay, the sporidia multiply by budding in a yeast-like manner. Let us see the germination of basidiospore and infection. The sporidia are dispersed by air currents or water. They fall on the corn plant, and there are some plant pathologists, they have reported that the embryonic tissue of all above ground parts are susceptible to direct penetration of the pathogen. Okay, and here let us see how the formation of gall takes place. In response to fungus, when the grain get infected by a fungus, the host cells in the infected region increase in size. And that increased grain is the enlarged grain is known as hypertrophic grain. Yeah, or the symptom is known as hypertrophy. And a number of hyperplasia are formed. Consequently, a tuberous outgrowth develops. It is permeated with the secondary mycelium. The fungal hyphae at this stage become additionally septate into smaller binucleate segment. These segments round off and separate into binucleate smut spores. Meanwhile, the host tissue in the tumor, accepting the superficial layer, disintegrates. The tumor is now filled with a mass of numerous black smut spores. Let us see the control measures of the disease. For the management of the disease, crop rotation is very good to reduce the disease intensity, and field sanitation is also one more method, and collect the plant residue or the infected grains from the field before sowing of the crop. All these measures that can reduce the disease for some extent only. And some resistant varieties you can grow. This can control 100% disease, and there are several fungicides available in market as per the disease, and use a particular recommended concentration of fungicide for spray or for seed treatment as per instructions.